In question 59, a uniform rod of mass M and length L is struck. Calculate the speed of the center of mass, angular speed of the rod, kinetic energy of the rod, and angular momentum of the rod. So this is solution 59. So first part, speed of the center of mass can be obtained by this formula. V will be Ft over M. Second part, angular speed of the rod about the center of mass. It can be found out by this formula. So it will be ml square by 12 into omega equal to half mv. Now after this, so after this we will have ml square by 12 omega equal to half L omega square, so omega will come out to be 6 Ft over ml. C part, kinetic energy, half mv square linear and the rotational I omega square. After this, I should have written it like I, otherwise you will get confused. I omega square. So after this, half m v is ft over m whole square plus half I omega square, half m f square t square over m square plus half m L square by 12, 36 F square T square M over M square L square. So it will be F square T square over 2M plus 3 by 2 F square T square over M, which will give us 2 F square T square over M. Angular momentum is MVR. M Ft over M, R is half, so it will be F L by 2 F L T over 2. In question 60, a uniform rod of length L lies on smooth horizontal table. Show that if mass of the rod is 4 times that of the particle, the collision is elastic. Solution 60. So let this be the rod. Now, by conservation of linear momentum, mv dash equal to mv. V dash is the velocity of the rod after striking. So v dash over v equals m over m, where this is the mass of particle and this is the mass of rod. So applying conservation of angular momentum, mvr over 2 equal to I omega. So MVR over 2 equal to MR square by 12 pi by 2T. So T will be MR pi over M into 12 into V. So the distance traveled will be V dash T, V dash एम आर पाई ओवर 12 m वी। सो आफ्टर दिस वी कैन राइट लाइक दिस ऑल्सो। सो वी विल गेट डिस्टेंस टू बी आर पाई ओवर 12 मीटर्स। In question 61, suppose there is a particle from previous problem. The rod has mass m. Find velocity of center of mass c of system. Find velocity of particle with respect to c. Find velocity of rod with respect to c after before collision. Find angular momentum before collision. Find moment of inertia. Find velocity of center of mass. Solution 61. So first things first, v dash velocity. So by conservation of momentum we will have the scenario v dash will be mv over m plus m. Then velocity of center of mass, let it be v dash, so it will be, let it be vcm, it will be m into 0 plus mv over m plus m, which will give us mv over m plus m. Now if body moves towards rod with some velocity v, so therefore the velocity of rod with respect to center of mass, let it be v dash, so m into 0 minus mv over m plus m minus mv over m plus m. Next, distance of the center of mass from the particle, so it will be distance of center of mass from particle will be m I by 2 plus m into 0 over m plus m. So angular momentum of particle before collision I omega mr square into omega for center of mass, it will be m 1 by 2, putting the value of r so it will be this square over m plus m square v by l by 2. So we will have m square VL over 2 m plus m. Now distance of center of mass from center of mass of rod, m cross 0 plus m by 2 m plus m ml by 2 m plus m. So therefore angular momentum in this case mvcm r dash cm. So putting all the values, m minus mv over m plus m, ml by 2 m plus m, we will get m square v over 2 m plus m square in minus. Only the magnitude will be positive. E part, moment of inertia of system will be equal to moment of inertia due to rod plus moment of inertia due to particles. So it will be mi square by 12 plus ml square by 12 ml by 2 square over m plus m square plus m ml by 5 square over m plus m square. It will be ml square m plus 4m over 12 m plus m. Then velocity of center of mass m 20 plus mv over m plus m. mv over m plus m. Angular velocity of the system about center of mass can be the torque can be given like this. So it will be m cross r m plus m v m cross r m equal to I c m omega. So m v over m plus m, m l over 2 m plus m, plus m m v over m plus m, ml over 2m plus m, equal to ml over m plus 4m omega over 12m plus m. So put simplifying everything, we will get omega to be equal to 6 mv over m plus 4m into 12. In question 62 we have two small balls A and B. The system is rotated with angular speed omega. A particle p of mass m kept at rest sticks to the ball A. Find the new angular speed of the rod. Solution 62. External torque is 0. So by conservation of angular momentum, ml square by 4, ml square by 4, ml square by 2, omega 1 is omega, I 2 will be 2 ml square by 4 plus ml square by 4, 3 ml square by 4. So omega 2 will come out to be 2 omega by 3 after putting all the values. In question 63 we have this figure. Two small balls A and B, each of mass m, are joined. We need to find the linear speed of the balls A and B after the collision and the velocity of the center of mass and the angular speed of the system. Solution 63. A part. So for A part we will have mv naught equal to 2 mv dash. So v dash will be v naught by 2. then net external torque is 0, so VCM will be MV naught plus 2MV naught over 2 divided by M plus 2M, MV naught plus MV naught over 3M, so VCM will be 2V naught by 3. In C part, velocity of A plus P with respect to center of mass 2V naught by 3 minus V naught by 2 V naught by 6, and velocity of B with respect to COM will be V naught minus 2V naught by 3 V naught by 3, and distance of A plus P from center of mass L by 3, and of B it is 2L by 3. So torque I omega, sorry, angular momentum I omega. So 2M V naught over 6 1 by 3 plus M V naught over 3 12 by 3 2M by 3 square plus M 12 by 3 square into omega. So omega will come out to be V naught over 2L. In question 64, suppose a rod with ball A and B in the previous problem is there. We need to find the angular momentum and angular speed of the system just after the collision, and what should be the minimum value of H so that system makes full rotation after collision. Solution 64. So in this, what do we have? So let's say this is the rod. Moving like this. When particle collides. So first part, the velocity of the particle is root 2gh. So ultimately m root 2gh equal to m 2mv. So v dash will be root 2gh by 2, and therefore angular momentum will be 2m 2gh by 2 into L by 2, so it will be ml root 2gh by 2. Omega will be L over I ML root 2GH over 2 ML square by 4 plus 2 ML square by 4. So we will get root 8 at 8G over 3L. B part. So for this, MGL by 2 equal to half I omega square. So what we will get? We will get Mg L by 2 equal to half 3 ml square by 4 into 8 gh by 9 gl square. So we will obtain H to be 3 L by 2. In question 65, we have two blocks of some mass. We need to find kinetic energy of the system and the speed of the block. Solution 65. so we will get this equations. And third equation, like this, or you can write like this. So by this equation, the acceleration will be like this. G over 5. Now B part V equal to root 2 AH. So root 2 GL to the power G into 0.5 over 5. So it will be root G over 5 or 1.4 meters per second. Total energy total kinetic energy of system half m1 v square plus half m2 v square plus half 18 square I omega square here it we when we put all the values we will find 0.98 joule.